Bird, let's talk about the origin of basketball. When did it start? When did you know this was going to be your sport?
I knew it was going to be my sport my freshman year in high school. It's amazing how the NBDL is still going on, and I'm honored that I was the first player to ever be drafted and the first player to ever be brought up into the NBA.
Despite some problems in the past, starting in 2005 when Andersen was in his fifth year in the league playing for the Hornets, it all started to unravel. He and his mother had a falling out over finances. His fiance ended their engagement, and in August of that year, his house was severely damaged by Hurricane Katrina. During that period, friends say Andersen made poor choices off the court. Mark Bryant, Anderson's mentor and attorney, says he recalls signs of substance abuse.
There was a combination of alcohol and drugs that I think bit him. I think family's still hard for him, because I know it's hurting him. I know it's hurting him.
His coping methods caught up with him in January of 2006, when Andersen tested positive for a substance on the league's drugs of abuse list, which includes cocaine, heroin, and methamphetamine. Abusing drugs on that list results in harsher penalties than marijuana violations, and Andersen was suspended for 2 years.
The darkest point was knowing that I had messed up that bad. As a child growing up, you know, your dream is to be a professional athlete, and you just destroyed that.
Andersen spent 4 weeks in rehab, then moved in with his close friend Mark Bryant and his family in Denver, who helped keep him clean. Bryant says Andersen passed weekly drug tests for 2 years.
I wanted to be the one to say, "I told you so." I didn't want to be in this other position where people were saying, "I told you so."
Andersen was reinstated in March of 2008 and returned to the Hornets. A free agent in the offseason, he wanted to head to the place where he turned his life around and signed with the Nuggets.
It was just when everything hit me all at once. I mean, it was just like, what do I do? I'll find the answer at the bottom of a bottle. That one didn't have the answer. Try cans. There wasn't no answers in the bottom of cans. You saw one problem, 10 more come along. Pick myself up because I had fallen back in that hole. That part of my life is behind me.
I did want to come back and make a statement.
What statement did you want to make?
Look at me now.
Ladies and gentlemen, set the bird free, baby. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Drive up, bud.
place for some people have never been in their lives. Another day of paradise, baby. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, good job. This is a bird. This is a bird. One of the greatest ever. Give him a hand.
Everybody's been in the gym on a consistent basis. Ready, wanting it. Better than ever.
It's like Chris Andersen, the Birdman. It's nice to have a center.
One of the more interesting appearances in the NBA.
Chris Birdman Andersen excused from the team, his home searched this morning by investigators with the Internet Crimes Against Children Unit. Is the story still developing at this hour? 7 News reporter Marshall Sullivan is live now with the investigation that's been building since February.
And that's at the request of a law enforcement agency in California. Chris Andersen's home searched this morning. The sheriff's office telling us he's cooperating in the investigation and he is not under arrest. Chris Birdman Andersen, his mohawk, tattoos, and height gaining the attention of kids. His Larkspur home now gaining the attention of Douglas County Sheriff's deputies. Investigators taking evidence from his home this morning, part of an investigation with the Internet Crimes Against Children Unit.
In February, we were contacted by a California law enforcement agency, and they asked us to get involved with this investigation, and we did do that.
7 News learning whatever was taken from Andersen's home being analyzed at a computer forensics lab run by the FBI and local law enforcement. Based on the lab's own website, it helps examine digital evidence for a number of investigations, including child porn and internet crimes.
Mr. Andersen was home at the time that our deputy investigators were there, and they did speak with him and he fully cooperated.
Andersen's gained attention recently for his off-court work with children. In December 2010, kids in Cherry Creek got a surprise when Andersen dressed up as Santa. Earlier that year, we were there at a Centennial Elementary School when he spoke to kids about saying no to drugs. Andersen had been kicked out of the NBA for a year because of a drug abuse problem he overcame. Now he's away from the team indefinitely during this investigation. Tonight I spoke with an Internet Crimes Against Children sergeant. He tells me investigators need to be very specific about why they need to enter someone's home and specific about what they're taking and why. We asked for the search warrant. We are told a judge has it sealed. Reporting live, Marshall Zellinger, 7.
The Call 7 investigators. Breaking news on the DenverChannel.com involving the Nuggets' Chris the Birdman Andersen. We now know what evidence investigators are looking for on his home computer. Call 7 investigator Kelly Raybon is tracking these new developments for us. Kelly?
Teresa, sources familiar with the investigation confirmed to me that the Chris Andersen case centers around Anderson's involvement with a 17-year-old girl, and police are searching his computer to determine if he possessed inappropriate pictures of her or shared them electronically. Anderson's attorney refused to comment on camera, but he confirmed a statement claiming a female fan contacted the 33-year-old Nuggets player in 2010, representing herself as 21 years old. Anderson's attorney says she visited Andersen in person, but the teen girl later threatened to retaliate against him if he wasn't interested in a relationship. Thursday morning, agents with the Douglas County Task Force seized computers and other electronics from Anderson's home. Those items have been sent to the Rocky Mountain Computer Forensics Lab to be analyzed. At this point, Andersen has not been arrested or charged with a crime.
And the roar you hear is for the newest member of the Heat, Chris Andersen, his Heat career about to take flight.
A Manitoba woman is charged with an elaborate scam that put a dark cloud over an NBA star. Miami Heat forward Chris Andersen nearly had his reputation ruined when he was investigated for luring a minor. Then he was cleared of any wrongdoing. Crystal Gamansing shows us the complex hoax.
It's a tiny community of less than 100 residents. Easterville, Manitoba is where RCMP say a woman launched a complex and far-reaching online scam. The 29-year-old allegedly set up a Facebook account under the name Chris Andersen, as in the NBA's Birdman Andersen. At the time, he played for the Denver Nuggets. Posing as Andersen, the Manitoba woman then started seeking out relationships, eventually connecting with a minor in California. The RCMP in Manitoba were contacted by officials in Colorado wanting help with a child exploitation case.
Internet crimes are borderless. And as such, you know, the cooperation between the different law enforcement agencies from different jurisdictions is so important, and we can't stress that enough.
Canadian officials launched their own investigation, and after 8 months, RCMP charged Shelley Lynn Charche.
We can confirm that we have charged this woman with a number of charges relating to transmitting child pornography, possessing child pornography, extortion.
Five charges in total have been laid, but more are possible. Andersen's lawyer says at least now his name is cleared. His name was splashed across newspapers and blogs. In the spring of 2012, police raided Andersen's home looking for evidence of child pornography. The fake Facebook account, according to RCMP, was all a part of an elaborate extortion scheme.
It's absolutely, surreal.
The case is complex and strange.
In policing, you can never say you've seen it all.
Charche will be appearing in court next month. Crystal Gamansing, Global News, Winnipeg.
Fan favorite Chris Andersen traded on Tuesday by Miami to Memphis. He went through his first practice with the Grizzlies today. The Birdman did not play much for the Heat this season, but he was a vital player off the bench in the Heat's 2013-2014 championship run.
My first initial reaction is, you know, nobody really wants to get traded and be uprooted from something they've, you know, established and you create a relationship with that team and that organization, and you build something with their families.
Gobble, stretching the pick and roll.
And then you finish off with Bird, a guy who I was able to win a championship with him in South Florida, and our fans were just gonna fall in love with him day one, you know, just because of his will and his effort. He gives maximum effort every possession. He's gonna fly around.